Brett, stop.
He's
get off.
So emotional about this water.
No, that is not the case.
What I'm gonna miss about Miss Waters and video production is how we're all, video production is like my second family and we're all like a little tight family.
What I'm gonna miss about video production would be like the funny moments we've all had. That's something everyone's probably gonna miss.
I'm going to miss the fact that she was always there for us when we needed someone to talk to.
In the beginning, I came to video production with no prior knowledge of any kind of video whatsoever. And when I started learning, I think Ms. Juarez was the best teacher.
Ms. Waters has taught me a lot of life lessons. We've had a lot of one-on-one talks. She's taught me to be happy and not worry about anyone else.
It's to be productive and not procrastinate, because without being productive, you're not going to get anywhere in life and you're not going to get anything done.
Ms. Waters taught me everything about video production, from using a camera to the editing software, to the basic camera work, to the composition of the camera, to the audio and the soundboard and all that other good stuff that she taught me.
Ms. Waters has taught me a lot. Freshman year, she taught me how to do the TriCaster and technical director, and that actually means a lot that she taught me that, because that's what I want to do when I get older, so she kind of set me up for my future career.
You've taught me a few things, like patience, definitely, and how to work hard.
Ms. Waters has taught me, she taught me to accept myself. She taught me to like stop being critical of my videos, even though I still am. She gave me that lesson. She taught me how to like, she allowed me to break some of the barriers that I would have if I wasn't in video production. And those are some of the things she taught me with all of her lessons and with the talks that me and her have had.
I do not know much about Ms. H2O besides the fact that she has children.
Well, I know a lot about Fiji. I know. I know she has a brother and a sister, and they're both in art fields. One's in, I think, is a dancer, and the other one teaches music.
She's in Boston right now while we're recording this, because her daughter's graduating from college. I know that she had a dog, and she had to put it down, and she got a new puppy. Her favorite color is purple.
She has a water company.
She has her own little company with her husband, Waterworks.
I know her favorite movie, I think, is Edward Scissorhands.
Her birthday is April 28th.
Her dad was a minister. That's about it that I know off the top of my head.
In my time with Ms. Waters, it was challenging, but yet it was a fun time. It was a fun experience.
Me and Ms. Waters had a good year. We had our ups and downs, but we had our fun.
She always challenged me when I didn't think I could do it.
She had like this way to make you understand things that I don't think other people could.
My time with Ms. Waters was a challenge, because most of the time when I had certain ideas, she would challenge my creativity, even though I still managed to pull it off somehow.
When we go to college, I'm not going to see Ms. Waters. I'm not going to have a teacher correcting all my mistakes over my shoulder and just sighing and taking off her glasses. I'm not going to have that anymore. And the thought of that is just like, it's mind-boggling, because we've done this for 4 straight years.
Well, my favorite memory was when I left class to walk around, and her in the class caught me all the way down building 4, and I told her I was making my rounds around school. But we had a lot of memories, but I think that was probably the most funny.
My favorite memory in our shop was when Jenna snapped on Anthony. Because we were having a discussion about how we all pull out our phones in shop, and Anthony was getting the talk from Jenna how he should not do it. And then like 2 seconds later, he just pulls out the phone and Jenna just snapped. Didn't I just tell you not to pull your phone out? The whole class was shocked.
My favorite memory from video production was probably the time that we all got back from Temple and we went to Chick-fil-A. And every single one of us, I think it was besides Brett, drank the milkshakes, and Malaysia was laying on the studio desk in pain. And we all laughed and we really bonded over those milkshakes.
There was a 10-minute play festival. And she walked up to me and she's like, Brett, do you want to do this? Is this something you feel like you could do? And I was like, okay. But I just, at that point, I thought it was like for everybody, like with the seniors and I did, because the year before all the seniors did it. So she came to me and she was like, Brett, can you do this? We're doing this. And I was like, okay. And then when I got in to the class, like no one else knew about this project. No one else was assigned this project. And she told me to start coming the first through third periods with like the underclassmen. And at that point, I just realized that Ms. Waters trusts me with some things, and I felt Ms. Waters had actually respected me as a filmmaker, and I think that's my favorite memory because that was the first time I think people respected me and my films. When I think about graduation and then thinking about the next day, I get a little upset because I'm not going to see most of the people as much as I'm going to. And then when I think about that, I just think about how we're not going to have the same experiences. Like, I can't just walk up to Julio the next day after graduation and be like, yo, what up, Julio? Like, I can't give Anthony a high five. I can't walk up to Jenna and give her a hug. I can't look at Corey and say, get off your phone. I can't high five Garrett, and the little things that we have between each other, we're not going to have.
And we're always there for each other no matter what. I want to say thank you to Ms. Waters because she's kind of changed me in these last 4 years. She's made me into a better person.
Thanks for being a good teacher.
I'd like to say thank you to Ms. Waters. First of all, for being my shop student, and second of all, for being, for like putting up with me and like my crazy antics with everyone else. For putting up with like my emotional stuff that I've been going through for like every year for the past 4 years. And she would just be like really patient. I thank her for her patience, that she didn't like just send me out half the time when I should have been. She didn't write me up when I should have been written up. I want to say thank you for being a friend and a teacher, because she was.
Thank you for being a teacher that inspired me throughout my school year.
She's just one of the best teachers I think I could have had all 4 years in video production. I think that basically sums up everything.
God bless you. And I love you. Even though I give you hell, I love you.
I love you, Ms. Awkwafina.
Scared me.
Baby, come back. You can blame it all off me. I was wrong. Goodbye.
Bye, Ms. Waters.
Goodbye, Ms. the hydrogen monoxide. That's a lethal weapon.
This was our idea.
Yeah, it's fine. It's ours. Yeah, high five.
Yay. Bye.
I think I'm going to cry, dude. No chain jack, and chain jack, and chain jack, and chain jack.